So pretty much this is a presentation on the history of industrial music, and it's going to focus on a lot of different groups and stuff that I've been kind of was researching over a lot, just being kind of interested in it. And so the first part, if you can see it, it says I like Skinny Puppy. I've been to the concerts. Nothing beats the Uptown Clubs when I'm in Salt Lake City, and it's nice to have darkness take the land every so often. And the second comment I got is, most underrated song on the album, pretty unknown, like the fact that FEMA camps have been built by the government since 1987 under Ronald Reagan. And now we've got a president who claims to support Ronald Reagan's policies. We've got big problems right now. 9/11, Hillary Clinton, 2020. As an introduction, Skinny Puppy. The first thing is really weird, and it's the targeting of industrial art and artists online, and has been a screenshot here of a kind of psychological attack on Facebook called the 1289-0032 research study, and it was in a over and over and over again put on my wall. And people sharing it in the comments saying, like, I know I'm one, and stuff all like that, and kind of disturbing that it definitely was targeting industrial artists. Losing control of your thoughts? Click here to learn more. So there's always been a weird people that do industrial music. Anyway, the second part is collaborating. And there has been some, you can see a screenshot of myself and my friend Devin here a couple years ago before we did some stuff, and always working on different ideas, visual stuff and audio. Industrial artists kind of do audio visual. And it has been doing that for many, many years, including bands like SPK. The most interesting part during the periods where people think that industrial is all about control, drug use, is industrial culture ties with false flags by FDA, government organization, about kratom. And this has been a really big deal for people that are, you know, do they are performers and industrial artists identifying as such. Here's a tag from Philly Kratom and the use of online presence to explain why the FDA is doing this. Two main parts are efficacy and the use of extreme sound and fashion wear, both of which people that would be knowing the history of industrial music would maybe know a little bit, but in the way of the history, two major points of that. To come back to the idea of the FDA false flags would be the going of canceling kratom and then saying now unregulated, weird, because I do know, have known some industrial artists to use it and so unfortunately abuse it, but it's kind of maybe always been there. Confusion. And to go along with this system, there's been the use of online streaming, which in 2018, there was a performance in Salem, Oregon, that went live. The use of live streaming and internet humiliation in relation to the history of industrial music. Here's a video of myself performing, and they're the biggest sound system in the little, tiniest little basement. And they did it live, and they said, okay, this is painful. I guess I know the answer to if I still want to check out this venue. I've always wanted to check it out, but not quite sure what is happening. This is the most upsetting part, to go back to the history of FDA and stuff. Looks like a dude on drugs. Wrong and wrong. A little more complicated than that, my friend. Or my foe. The kind of history and ties with that is the use of confusion in industrial. And the way in which industrials use as the extreme sound, Genesis, Briar, Pure, Orange. And just being, you know, everything being kind of a little bit confusing, but also responding to the confusion by the use of internet humiliation, unfortunately. On to the final bit. The era of research. There will always be continuing education in this, and people are always learning more about it. As you can see in the clips here from the Pick Your Side riots from Slab City, California, there's a large group of men and industrial artists, and they can see they have bats, helmets, and some of them have on an Evel Knievel outfit. This has maybe been the most toxic part of the culture. And there will always be research, and criticism is always welcome to any behavior. Industrial does not get a pass. Well, always be trying to understand it more and do a good job of putting it as everything out there. And that is the presentation for the history of industrial music. And the music before it was maybe that, and it could be something, you know, not that as well. Thank you.